Dear students, in this lecture we will discuss about the Racket parameters. So what are Racket parameters? Actually, in previous lecture on difference between Tennebo and Orgel diagrams, we have written the Tennebo diagram, they are the plot between E upon B and delta O upon B. So what does you mean with the B? So B is a Racket parameter. Racket parameter. What are Racket parameters? So Racket parameters are the inter-electronic repulsion parameters. As we see that the different electronic states, they are generated due to inter-electronic repulsions, due to spin orbit coupling, and after that, after formation of complex, then due to ligand field effect, they further split into different states. So these Racket parameters, they are responsible for splitting of any configuration into terms. So these are inter-electronic repulsion parameters. So we can say that due to partially filled d orbitals, the electrons in d orbitals repel each other. So if the d orbital is partially filled, like it is d1, d2, d5, d6, if it is filled like this, then the electrons will repel each other. So due to this repulsion, they generate a number of energy levels, states or terms. These are energy levels. So due to inter-electronic repulsions, they generate different states or terms or energy levels. And these energy levels, these depends upon the type and number of energy levels, depends upon the electronic configuration. So it depends upon the configuration. If it is D1, then different types of states will generate. If it is D2, then different type of states will be generated. So this depends upon how much splitting will occur, and number of energy levels should be decided by the electronic configuration of that metal ion. Now, the energy of these terms can be expressed as inter-electronic repulsion parameters. The energy. Now, we only know that this is a particular term, like 1D, 1S, 1D, 3P, 3S. These are different energy states. But these energy states, they can be expressed as inter-electronic repulsion parameters. As these parameters are known as, these inter-electronic repulsion parameters, they are known as Racket parameter. So Racket parameters, they are responsible for splitting of any configuration into different terms. Now, there are three types of Racket parameters, A, B and C. All three are inter-electronic repulsion parameters. The energy of each energy level is the sum of Racket parameters. In any electronic level, in any electronic energy level, the energy levels may be the sum of these three parameters. In some cases, in some energy states, A or B may be there. In some cases, A, B, C may contribute to the energy states. So these are their summation. It makes the energy of any energy level. So energy of each energy level or state or term is the sum of these Racket parameters. So in cases, likewise, for example, we will take the example of D2 configuration. For free metal ion. So free metal ion, in case of free metal ion, we know that this D1 configuration, it splits into five energy states, that are 1s, 1g, 1d, 3p and 3f. So these are five energy states that a D1 configuration splits due to inter-electronic repulsion. So this particular state, its energy level, its energy can be defined with the help of these Racket parameters. So it is the sum of its energy
is the sum of A plus 14B plus 7C. So these three Reke parameters, they can define energy of 1S state. Likewise, in case of 1G, its energy can be defined by A, B and C. Both, all the three parameters, they are required to calculate the energy of this particular state, that is 1G. So it is equal to A plus 4B plus 2C. And in case of 1D, the energy of 1D is also requiring three Reke parameters A, B and C. So it is equal to A minus 3B plus 2C. In case of 3P energy state, we can see that only two parameters required, they will decide its energy level as it is equal to A plus 7B. In case of 3F also, only two parameters, they can decide the energy of 3F state. So energy of this state is equal to A minus 8B. So we can see that these three parameters, they can all together, they make the energy of any state. So D1 configuration, it splits into these energy states due to inter-electronic repulsion. And this, due to this inter-electronic repulsion, these are the parameters which are responsible for inter-electronic repulsion. And energy level of this particular state can be defined by the sum of these Reke parameters. So we can conclude that about the Reke parameter, we can conclude some points that only B can be used to evaluate the difference between states of same multiplicity. As we can see again here, 3P, energy of 3P is equal to A plus 7B and energy of 3F is equal to A minus 8B. So if we subtract these two energy states so that we can calculate the difference between 3P and 3F, we get 15B. So energy difference between the terms of same multiplicity can only require one parameter, that is B. So if there are two energy states, it may be 4P, 4F as in case of D3 configuration, and in case of D2 configuration it is 3P and 3F. So difference between these two energy states can be represented only by one parameter, that is B. So B is a Reke parameter. So if we subtract from 3P to 3F energy level, then we will find that it is equals to 15B. So if we know B, value of one parameter, that is B, then we can easily calculate the difference between these two energy levels, and we can decide that this much energy is required to transit electron from this state to this state. So this is the energy gap between these two energy levels. 15B, if we know B, we can calculate the difference between these two energy levels. So this can be concluded that only B can be used to evaluate the difference between states of same multiplicity. As in case of 3F and 3P, it is 15B. As in case of 4F and 4P, it is again 15B. The next point of conclusion is that energy difference between the energy state of different multiplicity require A, B, C. So states of different multiplicities, they require all the three parameters like A, B, C. So as in case of these, we can see that this is 1S and this is 3P. So its multiplicity is 1 and its multiplicity is 3. So for calculating the difference between these two, we require all the three parameters A, B and C. So A, B, C are required to calculate the difference between the energy of two states having different multiplicity, while in case of states of same multiplicity, only one parameter is required, that is 15B. For transition metal ions, value of B is near to the 1000 centimeter inverse. So for complex ions, it should be less than 1000 centimeter inverse.
So it is not a fixed value, but for metal ions it is near to 1000 centimeter inverse. And if we know the value of B, we can easily calculate the value of C, because C is equal to 4B. So we can calculate the third Rekker parameter, that is C. And if we know the value of B, we can easily calculate the value of C, that is 4B.
Then next point, we can see that complexation decreases the value of Rekker parameter. So this is the case of which I have been discussed earlier, that is the case of a free metal ion. So in case of free metal ion, there are electrons in d orbital and they repel each other. So due to inter-electronic repulsions, they split into some energy states. After complex formation, so if this metal ion, it form a complex with a ligand, then the value of Rekker parameter. So if we consider B dash, the value of Rekker parameter for a complex ion, so that will decrease, and then B dash is always smaller than B. This is a metal ion. After complex formation, inter-electronic repulsion will decrease. So value of B also decreased, because B is the measure of inter-electronic repulsion. So after complex formation, this repulsion decreases. So this parameter will also decrease. So B dash is the Rekker parameter for complex. It is less than that for a metal ion. So it is always the situation that exists after complex formation. This decreased, this Rekker parameter decreased, and that will be discussed why this B dash value decreased after complex formation. That will be discussed in the next lecture, that is on nafloxetic effect. So nafloxetic effect, that will exactly tell us about the decrease in the B value of a complex of a metal ion. When it forms a complex, its B decreases, its inter-electronic repulsion decreases, and that will be comes under the topic nafloxetic effect, that will be considered in the next lecture of this series.
Thank you very much. If you like this video, you can like, subscribe.